I mean, when Jeff, when I, Christine Langham at the BBC, I have to thank her for introducing me to Jeff, because I said I initially didn't want to write it. I said, I've got this is an interesting story, and I think I want to pursue it. And she said, and I told her what my take on the story would be to Christine, with my producer Gabby Tanner, who was the person who kicked me in the pants to get this all going. And we found when I told the story, Christine said, "Well, you should write it." And I said, "Well, I'm not really used to, I'm used to writing comedy rather than drama." And she said, "You need to just need someone good to write it with." And she introduced me to Jeff, and now we're bestest friends. And it was a real revelation, because I learned from him, and we collaborated in the true sense that we both brought different things to it. And Jeff would often talk about the structure of the thing and the rhythm of the whole piece, and I was more about the sort of myopic detail of character and dialogue. But we both had distinct roles, and but it was a real pleasure. I mean, writing, I think, is as much fun as acting, I think, because you're there at the genesis of things, and it's very exciting. From my point of view, when I playing, I've played a handful of real people, including myself. When I played Martin, again, it was about. There's a certain amount of artistic license in the film, certainly the way we wrote it. Jeff and I wrote it, but the fundamentals. We were quite ethical, I think, about what where we invented things, where we didn't, and what we were quite specific about was that the fundamental sort of facts of the story were intact and are true, and the way we rendered the characters was that it was okay if we took a little license here and there. Certainly with Martin, I'd say it's 60% Martin or 50% Martin, and there's probably 30% me and 20%, you know, bits and bobs of something else. But the point is we honoured the characters in the way they're treated. I know, because I've spoken to Philomena since she saw it, and she's very pleased with it. I think she's seen it twice now, in fact. And
she'll see it three times tonight.
And so the first time, I think there was she's concerned, because of course anyone would be self-conscious watching someone portray part of their life on screen, I think she was happy. She said, but the second time she saw it, she enjoyed it, because she was watching it from knowing that it was that she was dignified by the film. But getting to know Judy, of course, when I was obviously slightly, when we were writing it, Jeff and I, you know, Judy was our sort of our number one on our wish list, and our wish came true. When it came to filming it, it was we weren't sure about who was going to play Martin, and in the end I decided it would be best if I did. I was very nervous about whether I'd be able to share the screen with this iconic figure sitting next to me, but I knew that I'd have to sort of bring my sort of, you know, I'd have to pull my socks up and pull my finger out and pull lots of things, but when I was on set, it was great, because Judy and I didn't spend lots of time anxiously talking about the subtext of the script or anything like that. In fact, we talked most of the time, apart from very occasionally, we talked about anything but what we were doing, and because it was such a quite difficult, heavy subject matter, it was quite a nice relief between takes just to talk about anything but the script, and there was a lot of laughing, a lot of laughter. I remember
there was
that.
There was a shared love of fast cars as well, wasn't there, which was interesting.
It was, yes.
Yes, yes. But, you know, it was very relaxed, and there's a lot of, in terms of the thing that Judy just said about the comedy, is that in actual fact, in this film, I had to really play the straight man. All the funny lines I gave to Judy, because it make me look generous and make her look funny. We didn't want to be over prescriptive and say this is the correct way you should behave, so it was important to sort of articulate that to articulate that, and not to make everything sort of, we didn't want to wrap everything up very neatly with a bow at the end of the story. So we wanted to show that there was, you know, there wasn't a sort of a neat resolution, but there was a kind of a tolerant equilibrium that could be achieved in the lives of these characters, rather than this complete this finality of this sort of conclusive closure, as the Americans say, on the whole thing. So it was important to sort of recognise that the different feelings an audience would have, and you can admire what Philomena does without necessarily thinking it's entirely correct, even. But it's quite nuanced. But we didn't want the ending to be sort of overly simplistic, if you like. Yeah.
And if there is a, it's not really that it's not using that word polemic. It's not a polemic necessarily against the institution of the Catholic Church. We're very, very careful to if there was any a finger pointed, it was not at the original events that saw Anthony taken away from Philomena. That you can't judge though then by modern standards. But what we felt was a more legitimate target was the way that it had been covered up for so long, and that they were artificially kept apart. Well, that was a greater sin.
Yeah, and I think the institution of the church, we were sort of, you know, it's not even being critical. The facts speak for themselves. In fact, that kind of those kind of, you know, practices went on and were tolerated, and it was a rather judgmental institution. But of course, what we wanted to do was separate the institution of the church from the people, the sort of very dignified people who lead these diligent, honest lives of altruistic, philanthropic lives, and we wanted to people of simple faith, in fact, and it was important that we differentiate between those individuals and the church as an institution. Which is what we wanted to do with Philomena, which is a lot of the script, in fact, was, you know, as I say, it was drawn from talking to Philomena and Martin and finding the truth from that. Sometimes you lead the witness.